What is going on, boys and girls? Mrs. Koebler here. And as you can tell, I'm huffing and puffing. I'm breathing heavy and perspiring. I'm all sweaty because I just biked up a monstrous hill here at Frick Park. So I'm in the middle of a mountain bike ride. Let's check out some of the trails before we get to this week's video, which focuses all on bicycles. So happy trails, here we go. So biking can not only improve your cardiovascular endurance, so to make your heart stronger, it can also improve your muscular strength and your muscular endurance, so specifically the muscles in your lower body and your legs. Biking is also great because you can bike at any age. So at your age, being young, you can also bike throughout your life into your elderly years. So it is a great lifetime activity to stay healthy, and not to mention, it's also quite fun. So get out and get biking. Okay, so before you go on a bike ride, there are three things that you want to do in order to be safe when you ride. And these are called the ABCs of bicycling. A stands for air. So you will want to look at your tire and find where it says PSI. Right before PSI, it's going to tell you a number range. That is the range in which you want to pump your tires before you ride. So I have my pump here, as you can see. And if I am riding on the trails, so on dirt, a dirt surface, I'm gonna wanna run a little bit of a lower PSI in my tire, probably between 40 to 50 PSI. If I am riding on the road or a hard surface, I'm gonna wanna run my PSI a little bit higher, so probably between 50 to 60. And most bikes' PSI range is anywhere between 40 to 60, so make sure that you check your tire pressure before you go out on your ride. B stands for brakes. So on my bike, I have a front brake and a rear brake. Okay, so on the left side, my left hand controls the front brake. My right hand controls the back brake. You never want to just push down on the front brake, because what can happen is it can cause you to flip over your bicycle and you could end up on the ground and hurt. That's another reason why you always want to have a helmet on to protect your head. So when you are riding, you want to put pressure on your right or rear brake and then your front brake on the left side to prevent you from tumbling over your bike. So B stands for brakes. And again, my left hand controls the front brake. My right hand's going to control the back brake. C stands for chain. You always, before you ride, you want to check your chain to make sure it's connected to the front and back derailleur. Another thing you're going to want to do before you start riding is oil your chain before you ride. And you can get the oil from a local bike store. So I always oil my chain, and I actually pedal the bike as I oil it. Then I let it sit for about 3 minutes. And then I come back with an old rag, I pedal the bike again, and I get any excess oil off the bike, and I'm ready to go. Now let's talk about correct seat height. Most bikes have a quick release lever on the side. So you release the lever, and you can adjust your seat height according to how tall you are. Now for me, if I were to ride my bike with the seat this low, this would not be the right way because my toes should just be touching the ground. When I go to pedal, I'm not going to be able to fully extend my knee when I'm riding. So when I'm riding, I look a little bit bunched up and my knees are not fully extended. So when you adjust your quick release lever, so this would be a much better seat height for me so I can get the most out of each pedal stroke. Another tip that you can do is if you're standing next to your bicycle, it should be right around your belly button or your hip, your seat. And again, when you get on and you have your pedal flat towards the ground, so not up here, right down there, your knee should be slightly bent. So that is the correct seat height. Use your quick release lever to adjust your seat. Now let's go over braking and stopping our bikes in control. If you can control your bike when you're riding, you're less likely to get hurt and stay safe. So for brakes, again, my right hand controls brake. Right is rear, back brake. My left hand can control the front tire or the front brake. bicycle is standing still when it's not in motion. If you try to change your gears when it's standing still, what can happen is your chain will pop off your derailleur and you won't be able to ride at all. So always be moving, always be in motion whenever you are changing gears. And in a minute here, we're going to practice pedaling and riding as we shift gears to get a feel for the different gears that you can bike in. Now, if you want to make it easier to pedal, you're going to click the bottom lever. So, for example, if you are going up a hill, you want to click the bottom lever before you get to the hill so you don't end up stopping and getting off your bike and walking up the hill. So it's easier to pedal and you're able to ride up that hill. So bottom levers, I have one on each side, makes it easier to pedal. If you want to make it harder to pedal, you're going to click the top lever. Okay, so the top lever is going to make it harder to pedal. So if you're on a flat surface, or if you're going downhill, you can click the top lever and it will make it harder to pedal so you can move faster. Now, some people have bicycles that have twist grips. So you literally twist the grip to adjust the lever. If you twist it towards you, it will make it easier to pedal. If you twist your grip away from you, it's going to be harder to pedal. So practice pedaling and clicking the levers to feel the different gears that you can ride your bike in. So if I click the top lever, it's going to be harder for me to pedal. If I click the bottom lever, it's going to be easier. So I can anticipate the hill coming, click the bottom lever, and be able to get up that hill. So go give it a try. Now let's talk a little bit about helmet safety. You always want to wear a helmet when you're riding a bike because sometimes we're riding on in the woods, so there might be mountains or hills. You might be on the road where there's traffic and cars. It's quite hustle bustle when you're on a bicycle, and in the event that you fall or you get hurt, you are protecting your head. When you put your helmet on, you want it to be nice and flat on your forehead. So if I put my helmet on and my forehead is showing like this, that would be incorrect. If I tilt it too far down and my eyes have trouble seeing, that also would be incorrect. So you want it to be nice and flat on your forehead. You also want to adjust. Most helmets in the back have a twist that you can make it tighter on your head. So I can click the back of my helmet to make it tighter on my head. So you can try the wiggle test. If I wiggle like a bobblehead, and if my helmet moves, it's not tight enough. So this would be correct because my helmet's not moving at all. But if I use the back adjuster and make it loose, and do the bobblehead test, my helmet is moving up and down my head. It is not secure. So make sure that you use the twist in the back to make it nice and tight on your head. All right. The strap, make sure that your strap is clicked. And usually, I mean, right now, my strap is a little bit low. You want it to be snug and secure on your neck. You can try the two-finger test. You should be able to fit two fingers between your chin and your strap and make sure that it's clicked. So anytime you ride, make sure you are safe. Earlier, I had gloves on. I actually ride with gloves on, especially when I'm on my mountain bike, road bike as well, because it helps lessen the vibration on my hands, the nerves in my hands. So I wear gloves as well. If you're really into riding, right now I have on mountain bike riding shoes. They actually, the traction between my foot and the pedal, it sticks, it's grippy better. There's also clip-in shoes that riders wear where your shoes literally clip into your bicycle. My bike back here has the clip-in pedals too. So the more you get into the sport, the more you can explore the different techniques and things with riding as well as bicycle safety. All right, let's review what we talked about for our biking lesson for this week. We started off by talking about the ABCs of bicycle safety. So checking air, brakes, and chain. We then talked about how to adjust your seat for the correct seat height while riding. We discussed how to properly change your gears on your bicycle, how to control your brakes while you're riding, so how to stop your bicycle, controlling your brakes. We talked about helmet safety as well. So get out, get riding. Happy trails, everybody. Stay positive. Peace. In the middle of my ride, I turn and I see some wildlife, a beautiful deer. This is why I love exercising outdoors. It's really